The article that I researched called Fighting the Good Fight looks at an in-depth reasoning as of why aggression is bad for the sport of hockey and the causes of extreme aggression on other players. This article talks about many incidents in the past of the NHL where players and superstars have been targeted by players that barely see the ice in a game and in some incidents ended their careers. There is a strong emphasis on why aggression is bad for the sport due to these incidents. It also goes into detail about how punishments given out to the players committing these incidents are not receiving big enough suspensions and are the reason why these incidents are reoccurring. The main problem with enforcers in the NHL is the idea that enforcers are there because they are demanding discipline from other teams while they can't even discipline themselves. A good example that was brought up in the article was multiple offender Matt Cook, who has been responsible for many cheap shots around the league, including his hit to the head on Bruins forward Mark Savard. Next, you'll see a short video clip of Matt Cook of the Pittsburgh Penguins clearly exploiting the head with a hit on former superstar Mark Savard, which ended his career short in the NHL.
To try to vanquish the Boston Bruins here today, but here's Lucic into the zone, drops it off, and a high shot sails over the shoulder. One of the Bruins just got blasted.
Matt Cook, the hit just as that shot was released, and they're going at Cook right now, and one of the Bruins on his backside. Is that Mark Savard? I don't know. Left-handed shot, 91, and then there's the hit.
Oh, blow to the head there, and Savard went down, and he is not moving any more than just a little bit, still on his back.
As you can see, Cook had no intention of separating his man from the puck and went straight for the head well after the puck was gone. The definition of aggression is a physical or verbal act that is intended to physically or psychologically harm another living organism. Now, there are two forms of aggression. The first type is instrumental aggression, where the aggressor's ultimate goal is not the injury of the person, but some other tangible like praise or victory. Then there is the other type, which is hostile aggression, where it is an aggressive act meant to injure another, which Matt Cook clearly displayed in this video. At this stage in Matt Cook's career, he should be banned from the NHL for good, considering this was just one of his multiple offenses. Aggression can never be completely prevented in any sport, but it can be reduced. If the league set more of an example or precedent and disciplined the players better with more severe punishments, there would be less incidents like these and players would aggress less because they know the consequences. It is quite often that after a player returns from a serious injury like a concussion, that people say they aren't the same player they were before because they are afraid it will happen again. Reducing aggression will prevent superstars from being vulnerable and fearful of events like these and will let them play to their full potential without worrying about being blindsided center ice or getting a cheap shot after the play. Players shouldn't have to be worried about skating up center ice and taking the risk of a fourth liner checking them in the head. Reducing aggression by raising the consequences would lead to a higher sport performance of superstars because they will never have the idea in the back of their mind of being injured severely or an injury reoccurring like it did in the past, and will let star players excel to their full potential.
Most wins in the Eastern Conference, Marc-Andre Fleury with 31. Malkin, galloping, to the goal, score!